Hi, I'm Rich with Inside HPC. We're here in New Orleans at SC14 at the SGI booth, and I'm here with Mark Fernandez. Mark, how you doing?
Very good. Glad you're here, Rich. Having a great show.
Well, yeah. I mean, we're almost done with this thing already, but I thought I'd stop by and ask you what's going on with the SGI Ice X machines.
Oh, very good question. Yeah. The Ice X is in production now, and it is a compute-focused platform. At this show, we're introducing the Ice XA, and it adds several degrees of flexibility. With the Ice XA, we'll still maintain the compute-only density that we have in our ice, but we have another blade available for that, which will enable accelerators, both GPU and PHY cards, and we have an even third blade will allow people to add hard drives and other I/O devices. So the flexibility of the Ice XA is what we're talking about today at the show.
Okay, great. Now, the fact that you can integrate that into the same blade pack, is that all about density and all the other goodness that you were selling with Ice X in the first place?
Well, yeah, you got one of the three.
Okay,
so,
yeah.
So with Ice, it's an integrated cluster environment.
Yep.
We focus on density,
yes.
Power cooling, and performance.
All right.
And so we're adding flexibility to that list with these three types of blades we have now available.
So what's the interconnect on the Ice X?
Oh, very good.
Yeah.
One of the knocks on the Ice X was we required you to have SGI's Hypercube. Okay. With the Ice XA, we're adding flexibility. You'll be able to have all-to-all, the traditional factory, as well as our classic Hypercube.
Okay.
All right.
So a choice of topologies.
A choice of topologies.
Okay.
A choice of I/O.
Yeah.
A choice of blades.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. And then, what are we talking in terms of scale? I mean, does it start at one rack and go up to, you know, petascale, or what? Where does it go?
Well, Ice XA, as you can see from our booth, is on our path to exascale.
Okay.
We certainly can't get there with Ice XA, but we think we can do that with the next generation, Ice EXA, Ice EXA, and it'll be out in about 2 years.
About 2 years.
Okay.
I'm
2017.
To do okay. Yeah.
2017 time frame.
Any big wins of note that you want to tell me about with Ice X, or is XA too new for that?
Yeah, we've got a couple of new wins with Ice X.
Yeah.
One's at NASA Goddard,
yeah.
And it'll be our fifth petascale machine on the list. So that's new. It's being installed this week. So I don't know if it made the list or not, but it's certainly one of ours. We also have the Idaho National Labs, which is on the top 500 and is the most power efficient x86 box on the list.
Holy so. Cow. Is that from the green 500? Did you do that cross number? Is that all they figure that out?
Yeah. No, it's from the top 500
okay.
numbers.
Yeah,
you do.
Right. They do have a power.
They do have a power there now. So
okay.
it's just,
gotcha.
And it's a real simple, just this is the power we use. This is the number we got.
Okay.
There's no trickery
okay,
there,
gotcha.
Right?
No stupid benchmarking tricks. This is straight up, right?
This is a straight up,
right?
Straight up, yeah.
All right. Well, this is exciting. So the XA, you're saying this is shipping? Soon or now or when?
We announced it this week,
yep.
And it'll ship in the March time frame.